Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Now, today I'm going to talk about what something is worth, right? Now, I was, by the way, thank you guys for making all the suggestions and the comments of all the videos. I've been looking into it. Never knew there were so many brands out there, guys. There's a lot of brands out there. Now, one of the suggestions in the comments that led me to Chicago Music Exchange, I was like just looking through the stuff and led me to a video about a guy going to Chicago Music Exchange or something like that. But subsequently, I found other examples as well. Old ass Gibsons costing $100,000, $50,000, you know, like $150,000, $280,000. I'm looking at it like, that's just crazy, guys. So what if it's old, right? Like, a lot of people say it's worth the money. It's not worth the money. It's not, right? Doesn't mean the people are not going to pay the money, but just because people will pay the money doesn't mean it's worth the money. There's two different things, guys, right? I put the example for you, right? Just because people will pay for it does not mean it's worth it, right? Two different things. Now, let me show you here. Example I printed out. Right, guys, this is President Bush of the USA got a pair of shoes thrown at him at a press conference. Now, why that was done, I don't remember, right? It was quite a while back. But the thing about this, which makes it a relevant example about why Gibsons are not worth the money, right? Although people will pay the money, doesn't mean it's worth the money, right? Is that this pair of shoes, the people found out what brand they are and what model they are, and the demand for this pair of shoes skyrocketed, right? The company that made these shoes could not keep up with the orders, right? Prices on the secondary market went through the roof, guys, for freaking this shoes, right? Prime example that people are nuts. They're willing to pay so much money for the Bush shoe, just to own Bush shoes. And it's not even endorsed by Bush, you know? It was crazy, right? It became a collectible, you know, like those bursts of the 50s. People were paying $500,000 for whatever the heck. Those are not worth the money. People are paying it. But what exactly are they buying? Are these shoes any better than before it was thrown at Bush? You know? I'm going to ask you a question. Are you looking to buy a guitar? Or are you looking to buy nonsense? Because all this extra money people are paying for is just nonsense. Whether it's emotional or whatever. Like, when a whole, just because a whole group of people got together and want something, therefore the prices go up, does not mean it's worth that much, okay? There's been comments below saying like, oh, well, there's a market for nitrocellulose. That's why people are selling it, you know? That's why guitar makers are putting it on there. I said, I know there's a market, just like there's a market for the Bush shoe. It's stupid. It does not make it a better shoe. It does not make it a better finish. It doesn't make sense, guys. People are buying because of emotion. They're buying because they just got way too much money and they don't care. You know, they could have like opened up a hospital in a third world country for children. No, they rather buy a freaking old 70-year-old guitar that's been like, you know, like just really old and stuff. It's like people, you know, they lose objectivity. Ridiculous, guys. Ridiculous, I'm telling you. Hold on a second here. I actually made these like 3 hours ago, left them in the pan, forgot I had them. I was sitting there, like getting angry about Gibson prices, wondering why I was feeling hungry. $200,000 burst, right? There's going to be some idiot that's going to comment, well, you're just upset because you can't afford a $200,000 burst. All right, I'll tell you. I do not have $200,000 to spend on a guitar. No matter, I don't care, right? If it was made of gold, you know, and the weight of the gold was like $200,000, I'll buy it. I'll take out a loan and buy it. I don't care, you know, but dude, I'm not going to pay $200,000 for a freaking wooden guitar. There's strings on it and metal bits, all right? Because that's what it is. Guitars are strings, you know? Metal, sorry. Got a piece of food stuck in my mouth. Let me finish this other one here. So good. All right, so what was I saying? All right, Gibson, not worth the money. All right, people only think they're worth the money, right? Because, you know, it's just not worth the money. No, it's not. You know, like, I just don't know why. I mean, like, maybe it is the, you know how I said earlier on a different video that the reason I started to look into expensive guitars, it's because I heard that, you know, there are premium stuff I can buy that will make my guitar hobby more enjoyable. You know, something premium. Wouldn't that be nice, right? It's like getting a second wife that is like hotter. So should I not have said that, guys? Put it in the comment below. You know what I mean? It's like, so, and I felt this way because I'm getting old. You know, I'm past middle age. I said, oh shit, I'm gonna die, guys. You know? I'm missing out on stuff. Perhaps the people who's paying $200,000 for the Gibson, maybe they're like 99.9 years old and they're dying tomorrow and they're like, oh crap, I better spend it today because it defies all logic and sense why anyone would spend that amount of money for something so stupid. It's a piece of wood with metal bits on it. Oh, speaking of pieces of wood with metal bits on it, thank you guys for suggesting always the custom makers. I look into them. And other brands and everything, I look into them. And I was like, wow, they're actually quite expensive because if I add up all the parts of the guitar I wanted, right? The wood, the Seymour Duncans, the CTS and the orange drop and the Switchcraft and, you know, premium nut, premium tuners. I'm looking at it. It's probably like $700 to $800 worth of parts and materials, right? I'm like $700, all right. So, I mean, where does all the rest of the money go? Yes, right, you gotta run a business, right? The luthier gotta pay for his tools and everything, and there's time and paying to, like, you know, milk bottles for his baby kids and all that stuff. So let's say at $50 an hour, which is, I think it's more than fair, 10 hours worth of work to do that, you know, that's another $500, right? So like maybe $1,200 to $1,300, you know, to make that guitar, shipping and everything. Now, you know, I thought about it, guys. So what I'm going to do instead of buying from someone else, I'll just gather all the pieces myself and do it myself. Because you think about it, you buy a Harley Benton, right? You're doing a lot of work yourself. You got to do the fret dressing and the setup and everything, you know, fixing the minor issues. That's at least like 2 or 3 hours I put into each and every Harley Benton at the very least, right? Not including not counting the fact that I have to pay for sandpapers and equipment and stuff like that, tools. I like, so yeah, I'm gonna buy the bits and parts and put it together myself. Why not? It's a piece of wood after all, with metal bits and springs and magnets.